Welcome to Friday Night Rivalries, where tonight's game features Grimsley and Page. It's for the Metro 4A Conference Championship. The winner tonight takes control in the Metro 4A. Stay tuned for the first half highlights. Welcome to Friday Night Rivalries. I'm your host, Walter Johnson, and you're watching the longest running highlight show in the state of North Carolina. I tell you what, tonight's game is the 66th meeting between Grimsley and Page. It's historic. It's one of the biggest rivalries in the state of North Carolina. Grimsley comes in 8-0. They're 5-0 in the conference, number one in the state. Page comes in 4-4. They're 4-1 in the conference, but a win tonight puts them in the driver's seat in the Metro Conference 4A for their conference championship. I tell you what, Grimsley is loaded. They have Brandon Faison. He's thrown for 1,650 yards so far this year to go along with 22 touchdowns. And then Mitchell Summers. My gosh, what can you say about the guy? He's averaging 12 yards a carry. He has 1,115 yards rushing, but he has 22 touchdowns on the season. They also have two wide receivers that get it done. You have Terrell Anderson and you have Alex Taylor. Combined, they have over 1,200 yards receiving for the year to go along with 17 touchdowns. These guys are fantastic. Grimsley probably has one of the best offenses in the state of North Carolina. Page, they've struggled a little bit, but of late, they've gotten it right. I tell you what, this guy, Maurice Andrews, is averaging 114 yards a game for the Page Pirates. He has 853 yards on the season coming in. He also has 7 touchdowns. Nigel Henson has struggled a little bit early, but he's getting it, coming into his own. 653 yards passing, and he too has 6 touchdowns, but he's starting to look better week after week. What does Page have to do? They have to slow down this juggernaut called Grimsley. I tell you what, they get the ball up and down the field almost like a track meet. They're averaging 54 points a game this year, and I mean, they've looked unstoppable. Page, on the other hand, is averaging about 21 points a game, but they are coming on at the right time of the season and maybe can make a push tonight. Grimsley, what do they have to do? Just be Grimsley. Be themselves. Do what they do. Give the ball to Mitchell Summers, and they should be all right. My prediction, you know what it is, Grimsley by a large margin. Stay tuned for the first half highlights right here on Friday Night Rivalries.
Let's go! memory. I need to have a word with your mom.
And the Jackson Henry extra point is good. 5:15 remaining in the first half. Your score, Grimsley 27, Page 0.
Thank you. Stays on Bradley, let's keep him. Again, at halftime, we're selling tickets for the 50-50 raffle. Mitchell Sutter's going to carry up to the 35, gain a foul on the ball. Pass is complete, number 5. High on down, little Rose. Bayvon Brandon on the keeper, little Rose. Brandon steps out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Roy Anderson running hard, got to about the 2-yard line. Third down, Brandon's pass. Complete to Alex Taylor. And the Jackson Henry extra point is good. 34-0.
Welcome to the Halftime Show. I'm your host, Walter Johnson. And what can we say but wow. It's been Grimsley, Grimsley, and more Grimsley. I tell you what, Brandon Faison, 12 for 14 for 197 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 to both Taylor and Terrell. Those guys are getting it done, but it's the Mitchell Summer Show. You're talking about a guy that just is amazing. 6 touches in the first half. That's it, just 6. 3 touchdowns. This guy is batting 500. He's Bo Jackson-esque. Every time he touches the ball, he could go the distance. So at halftime, it's Grimsley 34, page 0. Stay tuned for second half highlights right after this.
And it brings the ball across the 45-yard line. The first and 10. Brandon pass, the flag is complete. Number 1, Terrell Anderson. Brought down about the 20-yard line. Mitchell Summers off the left side, touchdown, Ballers! Summers fourth TD of the evening. All world touchdowns sponsored by A Son Never Forget, the DJ Ritter Foundation. And the Jackson Henry extra point is good. And you score with 10:32 remaining in the third quarter. Grimsley 41, page 0. Nigel Henson's pass is complete. In the right. Thank you.
gets his numbers to the outside. Touchdown number 5. Touchdown Wallace. Mitchell Thomas is fifth of the night. And the Jackson Henry extra point is good. And your score, 8:14 remaining third quarter. Grimsley, 48. Page 0. Henson on the keeper. Number 2, Elijah Jones on the carry for the Pirates. Brings the ball up near the 26 yard. Number 20 for the Wallies, Michael Williams on the carry. Michael Williams on the carry, picking his way down to about the 31 yard line. Gain of 9 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 1 from the 31. Michael Williams still running. Gets first down yardage. Down about the 22 yard line. Williams running hard. Down near the 16-yard line. And we have a winner, winning ticket number, Terry Myers.
Welcome back to Friday Night Rivalries. I'm your host, Walter Johnson. It's the postgame show, and what a game it was for Grimsley. Grimsley 54, Page 0. It was a shutout in the 66th meeting of Grimsley and Page. For Grimsley, Faison Brandon, wow, what do you say? 15 of 18 passing, 303 yards, 2 touchdowns, and then Mitchell Summers, 9 carries, 115 yards, 5. That's right, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 touchdowns on the day. Mitchell Summers was just explosive. He's our Friday Night Rivalries player of the game, and he's a guy that you want to keep watching week after week after week. But coming back after this break, we have some players we wanted to talk to about the game.
So we already came in thinking, we got to dominate. Just like my lineman said, we run behind them all the time. Like he said, right before my last score, run behind me, Mitch. Yes, sir. Ran behind him.
Punch it in. I tell him, punch it in all the time, baby.
Got to.
Him. We do it. We lay it on line for him every game, every practice. So he gonna get the job done.
Yeah, yeah.
How good did it feel to have your offense click the way it did today?
I mean, it feels good. We stayed poised at practice. You know, they're going to play cover two, cover four, and we just came out here just to prove that the gap is not closing, nowhere near closing. So, yeah.
Because Mitchell said that it was not about y'all playing against Paige, it's about winning the conference championship.
Yeah, every game, we treat every game like it's a playoff game. So we just come out and, you know, just play everything on the line. Don't play with no fear or nothing. We just come out here and just have fun and put on for the city. So.
Defense is good. We need to work on just getting after the ball, honestly, just hogging it down. But overall, we did good. We did a lot of stops, really big plays, a lot of fumbles, calls. Honestly, overall, good game. Blew them out 58-0, so I'm happy about that. But yeah, we did good.
So this. For us, this game was all about winning the conference championship. We've been talking about it and preaching it since the beginning of the season. We just so happened, like Coach Brown has said, we were just so happy to go against our rivals to win the conference championship.
Talk about having your offense click this late in the season.
We've been practicing harder and harder and harder and preaching for protection and them holes that I've been needing. And they understand as long as they give me a small crease, they can trust me and I'll get between it.
Playoffs, thinking about the playoffs now, how are you going to use this game to prepare for the playoffs?
I'm going to take one game at a time. However far God lets me go is what the plan is.
Welcome back to Friday Night Rivalries. You heard what the players had to say, and now it's time for our Friday Night Rivalries play of the game. Welcome back to the show. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching Grimsley versus Page. As always, we try to bring you the best rivalry games everywhere in Guilford County. Till next week, we have another big one for you. We have another conference championship. It's the 3A conference championship. It's Dudley taking on Eastern Guilford at Eastern Guilford. You won't want to miss it. But again, thank you for watching. As always, you can check us out on GCS TV2 or on the web at www.tenwebtv.com. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more great programming.
You got